It's ice hockey time now at Bolan-Sholokh Arena, where Russia took on Team China in the semifinal match. The winner of this game would head to the finals to battle for gold against Team Canada. Here's the coach for Russia, Alexei Chistiakov, and for China, Chiabo Guan. Both China and Russia now got ready to kick off this playoff game. Russia would have a very dominant first period here, and that would be the deciding factor in this game. It would be the first period that closes it out for this Russian team. Maria Batilova gets it started for Team Russia here with a slap shot from deep. Watch it again. Just slings it into that top left-hand corner there. Now Russia leads 1-0. But they wouldn't be done yet. A nice pass here from Elena Dergacheva over to Elvatina Shtareva. Gets another one in here for Russia. Watch the replay. Keep your eye on number 59 here. A beautiful pass to 68 for Russia now to lead 2-0 over China. And after the assist, she wanted a goal of her own. Russia now on the power play. Dergacheva gets it in here. Off the rebound, shoots it in off the stick of a Chinese athlete here. She will get credited with this goal. Watch here, right off the stick of China's captain, number 7. That one good for, once again, another goal for the Russian team. They wouldn't let up in this first period. Lydia Malievko gets one of her own, slings it back top shelf here. Watch this one. Bam, right there. They keep it going here with a little give and go action. Sosina over to Shibanovo, back to Sosina for another goal. Watch the replay on this one. A great pass gets it wide open right at the top of the net. You'll remember Russia's Shtareva from the second goal of the game, but she wanted more. A slap shot from the top right down the left side of the goalie. That one will be her second of the game and bring Russia up to 6-0 over China. And to end the first period, Nina Pirogova puts another one in top left-hand corner. Now Russia at the end, 7-0 over China. The Chinese team came out on fire to start the first period, though. Here's Yingying Guan with the first goal for this Chinese team. Take another look at it right past the left side of the goalie. And Russia would be at it again here. Tons of action from this team. A nice shot by Neon Tien is stopped, however, by this Russian team. They're going to take it back the other way with a shot of their own. Ludmila Belikova gets it to the Chinese goalie. Just misses the net here. Watch this again from Chinese athlete. Right around, stopped by the goalie, and Russia kicks it back out. They would be successful in their next attempt with a pass by Maria Batilova into Fanuza Kadarova. Watch this. Just puts it right past the goalie. Goalie had no chance on this one. Watch how quick this is. Boom, right to the back of the net. The next goal for China goes to Anna Shokina. Makes this one look easy. Finds the 5-hole. Right in front of the goalie, just puts it in there, and it's another one for Russia. The last goal of the game is a Russian player as well. Fanuza Kadarova gets her second of the game now. Watch her. Dizzles around the defender. Top left-hand corner. That one is good for 10 now for Russia. At the end of the game, the Chinese just could not come back from the 9-point deficit. Russia would take this one 10-1. Over this Chinese team in this semifinal match. They will move on now to play Canada in the final game in their quest for gold. At the end of this one, the shots on net are what did it, 50-15 between Russia and China. Let's head over now to Halyk Arena to catch up with the men's hockey. The quarterfinal game between Canada and Latvia would send one team to the semifinals and one out of the quest for gold. Heading into this one, Canada is undefeated with 3 wins. Latvia not far off with a 2-1 record. We saw Russia and Japan battle it out yesterday, and now the winner of today's game will face Russia in the next round. Canada and Latvia played in front of a sold-out crowd here at Halyk Arena. And officials from Sweden, the Czech Republic, USA, and Kazakhstan got some great action as the game went on. Take a look now at Canada's starting lineup. We see the teams here exchange some gifts, ceremonial tip-off there, and the starting lineup for Latvia. Their head coach is Gints Bikars, and for Canada, Brett Gibson. As the game got underway, Latvia would have an absolutely great game, but for this period, it would just be Canada who would put the puck in the net. You can watch some early action from both teams as it gets physical out there, but Gibson would remain calm. And you can see why: a couple passes here and a shot from Alexander Basso gets a wide open Pierre Olivier right in front of the net for the first goal for Canada. Take a look at this one. Morin chucks it right in there past the goalie. Great goal. Canada wasn't done in this first period. You can see Scott Simmons behind the net gets it out to Corey DeRoche, and he slings it in there. Take another look at this one. Here comes Simmons over to DeRoche, and it's in. At the end of the first period, Canada leads 2-0 over Latvia. But don't count Latvia out just yet. Oleg Sislenikovs, he gets wide open in the front, puts it in front of the net. That one is good for one for Latvia. Watch it again here. Mara Stilveka gets right in front of the defenders, slings it back, and Sislenikovs gets it in. Now, they wouldn't be done here in this first period. Looking to tie it up, Olaf's Oplex gets it up to his teammate. Slings it in right in front now. Tied 2-2. Here it is, Sislanikovs on a hot streak by himself. Steals that one and gets it up. That's going to be an assist for him plus his earlier goal. But Canada not happy with the tie game here. Here's Michael McNamee, misses the puck and then shoots it in. It's off the foot, actually, of Latvia's Yanis Bulatis. We'll watch this one again so you can see it a little closer. Right off the foot as he falls down, he slides it right in. Now Canada leads 3-2-2. The coach of Latvia, Gints Bikars, not happy with that one. And he wouldn't be happy with the third period either. Canada, the only team now to score in this last period. As Slater Duggett slides one in there for Canada on the power play. Now they lead the way 4-2. A good little rebound there from his foot. He's able to get it right past the goaltender. Canada happy with that one. And they should be happy. They'll continue to be happy here as Charles David Baudin slap shots and the rebound right into the stick of Michael McNamee. That one is the second goal for the assistant captain of Canada just in this game alone. He has had quite the tournament so far. No wonder that huge smile is plastered across his face. And here at the end, Latvia has one more shot at the end of the third to get one more goal, but that one will not fall. Canada takes this one 5-2-2 over the Latvian team. They will move on to play Russia in the quarterfinals. Latvia is out of the gold medal round now. Here's Canada, moves on from the semifinals. Very happy for this team. Shots on net here, Latvia 23, Canada 38. A couple other discrepancies as well. 14 penalty minutes for Canada, only 10 for Latvia. On the other end though, 25% power play efficiency for the Canadian team. They won 45-21 faceoffs. Now, Czech Republic and Slovakia will play later tonight.